Hi everyone! You've probably heard about Entra ID conditional access before, but did you know that combining ID protection with conditional access is one of the most powerful ways to prevent account compromise while also reducing the burden on users? That's because Entra only triggers these policies when ID protection detects risk. These policies also save time for your IT admins, security analysts, and help desk staff by guiding users to self-remediate. We are going to walk you through how to deploy identity protection policies in your environment. Eitan, can you help us understand how an organization can use ID protection policies?
Of course. Before you dive into creating a policy, you should first align with stakeholders in your organization and educate and prepare users for the change. Users must have multi-factor authentication, MFA, registered to benefit from these policies. You should also review the risk reports in ID protection to investigate any risks you may have missed or dismiss risk that's already been remediated. Now you're ready to set up your policies. Our most popular policy is our sign-in risk policy. With it, you can respond by requiring MFA and even reauthentication when we detect real-time sign-in risk on a user. This forces your good users to prove their identities before signing in while helping to keep bad actors out of your environment. Let's dive into the policy engine. Our risk-based identity protection policies utilize Microsoft Entra Conditional Access as the policy engine. In conditional access, you start by naming your policy and assigning who the policy will apply to. Then, select which target resources, that is, applications being accessed, you want to protect with the policy. We suggest protecting all cloud apps. Next, under conditions, choose the sign-in risk level you want to trigger on. For this policy, let's target medium and high risk. Then, use the grant and session controls to choose the experience users will get if ID protection detects sign-in risk. We recommend MFA plus reauthentication every time. If you're ready to enforce the policy, set it to on and hit save. If you want to run the policy in silent mode and observe its potential impact, set it to report only and save it. You can then use the Insights blade to check on the status of the policy and refine it until you're ready to deploy. As a note, because this policy requires MFA to grant access if a user is at or above our risk threshold, users who do not have a second factor set up will be blocked by this policy. We don't allow users with sign-in risk to register for MFA. So that deals with real-time risk mitigation. Megan, what can we do to mitigate risk that's detected offline?
We can set up a user risk policy. When a user is at risk in ID protection, we believe that there is a possibility that their credentials have been compromised. The higher the risk level, the higher our confidence that the compromise occurred. User risk policies allow you to create policies based off of that confidence level to block or require self-service remediation on risky users. A user risk policy is configured similarly to a sign-in risk policy in conditional access. We start by setting the users, groups, and the resources we want this policy to target. For the condition, we will choose a user risk level. Here, let's choose medium and high risk. For the access control, we can choose between blocking access and requiring password change. When we require password change, the user will also need to perform MFA. We recommend requiring the most secure method your users in the policy have access to. For workload identities, select the risk levels you want and choose the block grant control.
That's great, Megan. I should call out that some organizations will see Microsoft Managed Conditional Access policies in the policy blade, which covers some of Microsoft's best practices for how to protect users. One of them is a sign-in risk policy that requires MFA and reauthentication for high-risk sign-ins. If your organization is eligible, you'll see it at the top of your policy list. Microsoft deploys these policies on behalf of our customers in report-only mode and waits at least 90 days before enforcing them. In that intervening time, you can review the expected impact, add user exclusions, or enable it on your own. If the policy isn't a fit, you can turn it off and duplicate it to make your own custom policy. This is one example of how we are shifting to a secure by design experience.
Wow, that makes the whole process even easier when Microsoft does all the hard work. If your tenant isn't targeted for a Microsoft managed policy, but you are curious in seeing the impact of a risk-based conditional access policy before you build one, check out our Impact Analysis of Risk-Based Access Policies workbook. Before you even set conditional access policies, you can see an overview of the impact a risk-based policy would have had in your environment over a specified time range. This workbook is a treasure trove of data that will give you peace of mind knowing how many users would have been blocked, prompted for MFA, or required to reset their password if you had protections in place. You can also dive into the risks in your tenant by seeing the risk levels and detections that have fired recently.
I love how you can model different variations of a policy like in the workbook and see all the results right away. So no matter what stage you're at in your conditional access efforts, these tools will help you get the right risk-based policies deployed.
For more information, you can visit learn.microsoft.com/Entra/IDProtection and the Microsoft Entra blog.
Thanks for joining us and learning more about Entra ID Protection.